Yeah, hi. In this tutorial, we are learning Tally ERP 9. Now, first we'll understand, okay, what is Tally ERP 9 with GST. So, we are learning Tally ERP 9 with GST. Now, first we'll understand what is Tally ERP 9. Tally ERP 9 is a Windows-based enterprise resource planning software. The software handles accounting, inventory management, order management, tax management, payroll, banking, and many such requirements of the business. It supports all day-to-day process from recording invoice to generating various MIS report. Tally accounting software is a software used for financial accounting purpose. It is provided by Tally software, okay, and it is a business standard accounting software. Now, after understanding Tally ERP 9, we will understand, okay, little bit about GST. That is, goods and service tax is a value-added tax levied on most of goods and service sold for domestic consumption. The GST is paid by consumer, but it is remitted to the government by the businesses selling the goods and service. In effect, GST provides revenue for the government. Now, third thing that we'll be learning, okay, how to install Tally ERP 9. You have to just Google in that Google, you have to just type, okay, Tally ERP 9 download, and afterwards, okay, the Tally official website will be open, and then here you need to download. And after downloading, okay, you have to run the setup file. After running the setup file, okay, you will see, okay, the Tally icon in your desktop. I'm just double clicking on the Tally icon. Now, after clicking on the Tally ERP icon, okay, this screen will appear. So we have installed, okay, the educational mode. So you have to press W work in educational mode and press enter. Then it will ask to select company or create company. So you have to go to the create company. Since I have already created a company, I'll just show you how to create a company. So when you click on create a company, this option will open. Now again, I'm repeating what I have told you. You can open, okay, Tally ERP 9 software by double clicking on Tally ERP 9 icon. The first step is how to create a company. And without creating a company, you will not further move to create masters and recording of business transaction. Now you can see the create company option over here. I'll just read, okay, all the options. You can easily create a company in Tally ERP 9 by using the following path. Gateway of Tally, Alt F3 that I have pressed, click on create company. Now you have to go through the above path and fill the information related to your company. Now you can see, okay, the above field you need to fill it, like company, address of the company, contact details and other information. Then click on create company. Once you click on create company, then below screen appears. See the screen that you can see on your screen right now. Address, enter the company address. Then country, select country, state, enter state like Telangana, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Rajasthan. Enter pin code, enter telephone number, enter mobile number, enter fax number, enter your company official communication mail ID, website, enter your company website address, financial year beginning from when, from the date you had started the business. Then security control, if you press yes, then it will ask you to put a password over here and you have to remember the password. This is very useful option. By activating this option, you can avoid unauthorized access of company data. Use Tally audit features. Once you click over here yes, then this option will come. Now what does this option says? Okay, this feature is for chartered accountant to audit the company books of account directly. Then we have open, okay, our company, okay, in the education mode. You can open your company Tally if this feature is enabled in education mode. In off, the feature was enabled because we had opened the education mode. Now everyone knows about Tally. It is free for educational purpose, and in this you can able to enter or post any entry. Now as you had seen, okay, I had posted all the entries over here. Mailing name, then address can be like 2-3 language, like which, how much is the length of your address. Then country had written India, state Rajasthan, pin code, then mobile number, fax number, website if you have, then books beginning from. If I put security control yes, it will ask me, okay, then name of the administrator, everything. Okay, it will ask. This is basically we will use no only. We don't want it to set a password over here. Then afterward you have to press enter, enter, enter. Then you have to click yes. So your company will be created. Since my company is already created, now directly I will move okay onto my first screen. Okay, after creation of the company, you will see this okay Gateway of Terry screen. Now Gateway of Terry screen is the screen okay where you will see first. In that, okay, the first heading is there in the Gateway of Terry, that is Masters in Gateway of Terry. Now, primarily, there are two options in Master in Gateway of Terry. They are first is Account Info, now and Inventory Info. Now, Accounts Info includes everything about ledgers, groups of different ledgers, budgets, scenario, voucher types, and statutory info. In other words, anything accounting apart from passing entries has to be done through Accounts Info. If you want to create or alter a new ledger, there's this all the options we'll see later, but I'll just give an introduction. If you want to create or alter a new ledger, you have to go through Accounts Info. Or if you want to create a new voucher type, you can create it through Accounts Info. You can also create budget as well as scenarios to see how the accounts look in certain condition, and these options are contained in Account Info. Account Info is under Master option that we had seen okay in Gateway of Terry, because it allows you to create and alter different accounting option. Now second option is Inventory Info. Now as the name suggests, it includes everything about stocks or in accounting terms inventory. Similarly to Accounts Info, you can create and alter stock items, stock groups, voucher types, as well as statutory info. This is where you can create stock items and groups them on the basis of stock groups for further classification of your goods. For example, you have a mobiles and computer at your shop. You can create a group called mobiles and put stock item in that group, known as Apple iPhone X and Samsung Galaxy S8. In the same way, you can create stock item groups called computer and put in the stock items like Samsung laptop and HP laptop. You can also create units of measures in Inventory Info, which is very necessary. Units of measure will be numbers, since we can calculate mobiles and computers in number. It can be kg, that is kilogram, liters or feet as per your stock. Now let us move on the next part of Terry, which is transaction. Now in transaction part is one of the most used component on the Gateway of Terry screen. It is used for creating accounting vouchers as well as inventories in Terry. Similar to Master, transaction in Gateway of Terry also contains options. They are accounting vouchers and inventory vouchers. Now there are four basic accounting vouchers in Terry that you can see over here at the side. Here you can see they are contra, payment, receipt and journal. Apart from that, there are some more vouchers such sales and purchase, credit and debit note, memos and reversing journal. Whenever you need to create or pass any accounting entry, you have to go to the accounting voucher in Terry. It is under transaction because whether you create an accounting voucher, it is a kind of transaction. Now, inventory voucher are mainly used for entering pertaining to manufacturing or assembling business. Whenever you have a number of components that you manufacture a finished product, inventory vouchers are used for recording that entry in Terry. For example, you manufacture a pen from ink, nib and a body. This kind of entry can be recorded in Terry with the help of inventory vouchers. There are other advanced inventory vouchers such as rejection in, rejection out, delivery note, receipt note and godowns, which are used in accounting entries for manufacturing purpose. Moving on to the third component of Gateway of Terry screen is utilities. There are two options again in utilities in Gateway of Terry: import data and banking. By using this option, you can import masters, vouchers and bank details in Terry. You can import all of this in Terry from here. You can import masters and vouchers in Tally in Tally XML format only. That simply means if you want to import masters and voucher in Tally, they have to be exported from Tally itself. Although you can import bank details in Excel format. Now next option is bank itself. Banking is one of the new options which was not present in the earlier version of Tally. With the help of all the options in banking, you can easily maintain all of your banking information at one place in Tally. There are options like check printing, check register, bank recognition, deposit slips, payment advice and post-dated summary. You can simply print a check from Tally. Isn't it amazing? Bank recognition is also one of the features that can help you a lot and save your time in accounting. Deposit slip is another but is nothing but a list of check deposit slips and cash deposit slips, all of which you can access through Gateway of Tally. Now let us move on to the last and the second most important component of Tally after transaction is reports. It includes balance sheet, profit and loss account, stock summary and ratio analysis as four basic reports in Tally. If you do not know all of the reports above automatically prepared in Tally on the basics of how we create our accounting entries, and therefore they are called as reports. The definition of reports is that it takes information from what we enter and display it in a concise and the needed format, which in our case may be balance sheet or a profit and loss account. Now first is balance sheet. You know what the balance sheet is. In case you don't know, in simple words, it displays all your assets and liability in one place so that you can take important decision about your business. Then profit and loss account displays all your business transaction in this year, and on the basis of that you can see whether there is a profit or loss this year. Again, profit and loss account is also automatically prepared in Tally with the help of entries we create. Then stock summary displays all the inventory that you have or sold or is manufactured by you. It is really a neat and clean way to see at one instance how much you have in stock. You can also check the profits that you made by selling the items that were in your stock in stock summary. If you have created stock market entries in Tally, then stock summary will show all shares that you have purchased as well as sold. Next option is ratio analysis, which is generally not used by people except professional. Ratio analysis contains several principles, accounting ratios and principles group of accounting in Tally. On one side there are principles accounting groups, and on the other side there are principal accounting ratios. The reason ratio analysis is only used by professionals only because they are able to understand the true meaning of this ratio and take an informed decision. Ratio analysis is a great report in Gateway of Tally only if you know what the ratio actually means. And the next is display. Now display option after ratio analysis is display. If you notice, there is some space after ratio analysis and then display option is situated. It is because it contains 35 plus reports, registers and statements which are required for running a business, including GST reports. That includes all accounts book, day book, accounting statements, statutory report, which contains GST returns and many other statements and reports which are necessary, which you will require even if you are running a small business. After display option, there is a quit button if you want to get out of the Tally. I hope in this you have understood the introduction of Tally, GST, how to install Tally ERP9, how to create a company and the Gateway of Tally screen. In the next tutorial, we'll continue further.